Hi there, and welcome to the first of the policy updates that we intend to put on the web to keep you up to date with our thinking in areas that are very important to the government. This week, I'd like to talk about an area that's close to my own heart, education. Education is a great liberator. It's the key to unlocking the potential of young New Zealanders. We are determined to do better for the 1 in 5 young people who currently leave school without the skills or qualifications they need to succeed in the modern economy. In our first year in government, we've made real progress towards that goal. We've introduced groundbreaking national standards in literacy and numeracy. From next year, every child at primary or intermediate school will have their progress in reading, writing, and maths regularly assessed against national benchmarks. The standards will help teachers identify children who are slipping behind or having problems. We've also introduced mandatory plain English reporting of national standards. Schools will report children's progress to their parents in Plunkett-style report cards. That way, mums and dads will have a clear idea of how their children are doing compared to where they should be. And they'll know what they can do to help their kids get to that level. We've backed up national standards with an extra $36 million over 4 years. This will assist schools to give more help to children who aren't reaching the benchmarks. Lifting education standards is just the first of our education priorities. It's important that our schools are modern and that they encourage children to be at school and to learn. That's why we're investing $523 million in a 21st century building plan. We are building new schools, improving existing schools, and future-proofing tomorrow's classrooms. We've started work on 3 new schools already. And we've ticked off improvements to another 112. It's also important that school children have the teachers they need. We want to encourage more teachers to work in hard-to-staff areas and subjects. So we've created 1,800 opportunities for graduate teachers in our new voluntary bonding scheme. This will help teachers pay off their student loans. We've also introduced a 10% voluntary repayment bonus on student loans to help graduates from all disciplines pay off their loans faster. Another priority for the government and students is boosting trades training. For some teenagers, school may not be the best place to learn. So we're providing a new vocational education option for 16 and 17 year olds. Under our youth guarantee scheme, we've created 2,000 additional places in polytechs and private training establishments. This will allow teenagers to take part in a fees-free course that fires up their imagination, whether it's something like agriculture, tourism, or plumbing. We're also developing 6 new trades academies in secondary schools around the country. These will provide trade training opportunities to teenagers while they're still at school. Another way to keep kids engaged and learning is through school sport. We've provided an extra $82 million boost through our Kiwi Sport program for schools and sports clubs. Thousands of young Kiwis will get more opportunities to kick around a ball, throw a discus, or join a cricket team. We're also boosting school holiday opportunities for young people from less wealthy communities. By 2011, we'll provide 30,000 extra places in holiday activity programs, and we've created 100 places in a Prime Minister's program for teenagers who have made a concerted effort to turn their lives around. These are just our first steps. We'll have a lot more to say soon about lifting achievement in our schools and improving education for all children. In the meantime, we want to hear your thoughts on how we can improve the skills and qualifications of the next generation of New Zealanders. Please comment on this video or leave a post on my website, www.johnkey.co.nz.